Good morning, students. This is your faculty Neha working at BRGS. Today I will be starting with a new chapter of history, and the name of the chapter is Mauryas and the Kushans. So, kids, before going ahead with the lesson, let me quickly brief you what we will be learning in today's class. In today's class, we will learn about the first ever empire of India, which was the Mauryan Empire. We will also learn about Ashoka's life, his achievement, and the contributions done by him. We will also learn the history of Kushans, their administration, and their contributions in the field. As well as we will be locating the regions of Ashoka Empire on Indian map. Okay. Now let's get started with the Mauryas first. Kids, India's first empire was Mauryan Empire. They ruled from Magad, that is, you also call it as Magadha, and Chandragupta Maurya, Bindusara, and Ashoka, these were the important kings of this dynasty. This dynasty was established by Chandragupta Maurya. And students, though the sources materials are less, the available sources provide valuable information on Mauryas. I will be taking the following source which give us the information of the Mauryans. So let's go ahead. The first one is Megasthenes Indica. Megasthenes was in India as an ambassador of Greeks in the court of Chandragupta Maurya. And he has recorded his experiences at Pataliputra, which was Mauryan Empire, in his book named Indica. And the second reference sources is Kautilya's Arthashastra. Arthashastra is written by the teacher and the prime minister of Chandragupta Maurya. And he was Kautilya. He is also known as Chanakya or Vishnugupta. Arthashastra is written in Sanskrit. It outlines the basic principle on administration, foreign affairs, and judicial duties that the king has to know. By reading this book, one can understand the politics, economy, administration, social, and other aspects of the Mauryan period. And the next one is Inscriptions of Ashoka. Inscriptions are the authentic source of information on Ashoka. They tell about the boundaries of Ashoka's empire, as well as his efforts to spread the Dharma and the details of Kalinga battle. Now let's go ahead and study about Chandragupta Maurya. Chandragupta Maurya founded the Mauryan Empire. Chandragupta came to power by dethroning the last king of Nanda dynasty under the guidance of his teacher Kautilya at the age of 25. By this time, the northwest of India was ruled by the representative of Alexander till Punjab. In 305 BCE, Chandragupta Maurya declared a war against him, and the battle ended in an agreement. According to it, Alexander handed over four territories that included today's Afghanistan and Balochistan to Chandragupta Maurya. Moreover, he married his daughter to him. Now let's study about the famous king of India. His name is Ashoka. He was a son of Bindusara. He was also a governor of Ujjain and Takshashila during his father's regime. He suppressed an uprising at Takshashila. After the death of his father Bindusara, it was said that Ashoka had to kill all his 99 brothers to assume the throne, as per the Buddhist tradition. Probably there was an internal war among the brothers about 4 years. It is assumed that he ascended the throne in the year 269 BCE. And he waged a war against Kalinga 8 years later. This was the only war waged by him after becoming a king. Now let's go ahead and study about Kalinga War. Ashoka declared a war on Kalingas who refused to accept the rules of Maurya Empire in 261 BCE. The 13th rock inscription of Ashoka provides more information on the battle of Kalinga. Okay, according to it, Ashoka declared war on Kalinga 8 years after assuming the throne. In this battle, 150,000 prisoners were taken and 100,000 people died. Many more became refugees. Though Kalinga was won by Ashoka, he was disturbed by the death and the pain of the battle, and he decided not to wage war thereafter, and he decided that he won't be fighting any of the wars now or initiate in any of the wars. He considered victory of religion is better than the victory in the battlefield. And being inspired by Buddhism, he dedicated his remaining life to spread the message of peace. Ashoka accepted Buddhism after the Kalinga battle. He made donations to Buddhist monasteries and the viharas. He prohibited the killing of animals and birds in his kingdom. Ashoka declared that all his citizens are his own children. He declared that all should be loyal to the parents and respect their elders and the gurus. He wanted people to show compassion to the poor and slaves too. Live and let live, was said by him. He had installed inscription all over his kingdom to preach the message of Buddhism. Preachers were sent to another country as well to spread the teachings of Buddhism. He also sent his son Rahula and daughter Sangamitri to Sri Lanka. In 250 BCE, he organized the third Buddhist conference at Pataliputra. Students, did you know that Ashoka is called as the father of inscription? Till today, his inscription are the first inscription to be read. Students, did you know that Ashoka never wrote his names on the inscription? Instead of his name, he gave the title as Devam Priya or Priyadarshi. In this inscription, Devam Priya and Priyadarshi, Ashoka's reference appeared for the first time. Based on this, it was decided that Devam Priya and Priyadarshi are the same. Later in other inscription, the name Ashoka appears. Now let's study about the economic system during Mauryan period. There are evidences which prove that the lake and the canal system of irrigation was good during Mauryan period. The government was managing the agriculture sector. Prisoners of war and slaves were engaged in agriculture activities. Land tax was the main source of the revenue for the state. A farmer was expected to pay 1/4 of his income as a tax to the state. There were major roads connecting different parts of empire from Pataliputra, which was the capital city of the Mauryas. A major road to Nepal passing through Vaishali and Champaranya from Pataliputra was also there. A highway to Takshashila from Kusambi passing through the present Delhi and Punjab was there. Merchants were transporting goods on these roads to sell within and outside the empire. Kachu marked silver coins were in circulation in Maurya Kingdom. This period is marked as second phase of urbanization. Now let's get to know about the social system of Ashoka period. The social system was evolving out of the Varna based caste system of Vedic period. During this period, people born in higher Varna could migrate to another Varna and gain a better social acceptance and respect. For example, a Brahmana and a Kshatriya could interchange their status. Though the society was divided into four Varnas, namely Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and the Shudras, several castes were also present. Megasthenes records the presence of seven castes in Mauryan society in his book Indica. Indica does not record the existence of slaves and dasas in Mauryan society. Though slavery was in practice during Mauryan rule, it was less harsh than the slavery of Greek people and the Roman societies, okay? Comparing to that, these people has given little bit of liberty to the slaves. Shudras, the last in the Varna system, were employed as agricultural laborers and domestic helpers. Activity time, students. Now take a pause from the video. Pause your video for 5 to 10 minutes. Draw an India map and mark the following places in the map. You can refer your textbook for the further help. On the screen, you can see the chronology of the Mauryan Empire. Just take a moment, pause the video and go through the names of the kings who had ruled the Mauryan Empire. Now let's go ahead and study about the Kushans. The Kushans after the Mauryans are an important dynasty of India. They were basically from a nomadic tribe which has migrated to India from Central Asia. The Kushans defeated the Sakas and the Parthians. The other foreign communities settled in northwestern part of India and settled in Gandhar region. The Kushan dynasty was founded by Kujalakarpasis. Kujalakarpasis united Yuchi tribes under one leadership. Crossing the Hindu Kush range, Kujalakarpasis settled in Kabul and Kashmir. The noteworthy kings of the dynasty are Bhimakarpasis and Kanishka. The Kushans have greatly influenced Indian history and culture. The gold coins as a medium exchange were brought during the reign of Bhimakarpasis. The Gandhara form of sculptures flourished during the time of Kushan dynasty. Kanishka's rule began in 78 AD and gave a way to a new era called Shaka era. The Kushan dynasty prospered greatly during Kanishka's regime. Kanishka's kingdom spread up to Sanchi in the south and Banaras in the east and included Central Asia too. The capital of this vast empire was Bhojpura, present-day Peshawar, and Mathura was a significant town. In Kanishka's reign, the Kushans mainly minted gold and copper coins. Art and architecture was encouraged during their period. The spread of Buddhism was given more importance by the Kushan dynasty. The Kushan took Mahayana sect under their patronage. Buddhism received the patronage of King Kanishka and prospered to spread Buddhism. Kanishka sent missions to Central Asia and China. Under the leadership of Kanishka, the fourth Buddhist conference was held at Kashmir. Buddhist scholars like Asvaghosha, Vasumitra and Sangharaksha were the famous scholars of this period. That's all from today's chapter. Thank you very much for paying attention. Have a great day ahead.